Got it. Okay. Oh, what happened? Oh, that was weird. It was like grayed out or something. I didn't drain the mechanist. That would have got him out of the way, actually. Nowhere. Other exits out. Looks like no, looks like just that one gate. Yeah, don't push me. Not in the mood to die right now. So, I can't get there. It ends. She's down there. Can I see her? Pahtira! Is that her? That doesn't really look like a person. Who's looking over? I guess that is her. Hunched over a book. Well, dropping down there would probably hurt. Let's go this way. Because we want to explore anyway, right? What did that do? Oh. Oop. Okay. I see. Come back up. I'm afraid to get too close. He'll push me over. Hopefully just lead me right to her with no issues. You're gonna go back? You're gonna go down again? Well, I have to hit the lever from outside the thing. How's that work? Yeah, she's right down there. This is poor design. There should be a lever in here. Instead, I gotta hit the lever and then hop down. See that? Ugh. Haha! Good job, Samuel. How'd you get past all this stuff?
Well, well. You sure did take your time, didn't you? So, are you ready? The energy core is, as expected, still intact, but we'll need some cleverness to get to it.
Cleverness? This thing is colossal. Do you have any idea as to why it crashed?
Well, I can only speculate, but stalling technology is as genial as it is complex. They say that building Agnog took about 7 decades, and then, phew, just like that. A misplaced cog and the whole thing goes to shit. Must have been pretty frustrating for the engineers.
Huh. So this thing didn't crash here. They were building it to leave this planet? When you say we're going to deactivate the defense mechanisms, they seem pretty active to me.
I said I'll see what I can do, and that I did. I deactivated most of the traps, and if I hadn't done that, you probably wouldn't be here anymore. As for those Centurions, nothing I can do about them. Sorry.
Huh. What about the Guardians? They're tough too. And the Spiders. Alright, how do we get to this core?
That's pretty easy. Well, that is if you know what you're doing. We need to deactivate the energy current that surrounds the core. If we don't do that, anyone who touches the core will be turned to roast beef in seconds. So, this is what we'll do. You open the valves, and I control the flushing of energy. There are four valves in total. Open them all.
Right. And we're gonna have to fight through endless waves of these enemies to get to each valve, I'm sure. What book were you reading here? I can't look at that. What does this do? I guess that's not valve number one. Oh. Well, that was easy. I thought I was going to travel all over the place. All you have to do is walk over here and do it. You could have done that. Yeah, 3 and 4. I'm just gonna be cautious here.
Yeah, very good. That did the trick.
That was
take the call.
Remarkably easy. Remove the generators. How do I... Oh. What's going on? Ooh. That doesn't look good. Oh.
Must have hurt, didn't it? Sorry, this isn't personal, but I saw how you can fight, and with what I plan to do, I can't afford any extra risks.
Well, you did that on purpose?
There's no way I can let that old fool have the machine. It is a masterpiece, probably the greatest Starling achievement since they built this ship. And what does he do? He calls it horsed and treats it like a bloody pet. Why the heck do geniuses always need to be lunatics as well? Dal Terrawin is a damn fine tinkerer, but he doesn't even remotely understand the potential of this apotheosis. He sees the Centurion as some kind of crutch with which he can prolong his life. That's just pathetic. Immortality. Just think what you could do with it in the right hands. I will lead my people, the Starlings, back to their old glory. It's for the greater good. I'm sorry.
What are you gonna do now? Kill me? Punch me? Or just leaving. Oh, I'm blacking out again. Escape from the generator room. Oh! The glacier is melting. I have to get out of here. Wait, where's the... The water level's rising. Well, that could help me. Maybe. Where's the way out? Should I just wait until we can get up there? Or can I find another way up? I'm gonna shove a honey nut bun in my mouth. Because apparently I'm a little injured. The water level is definitely still rising. Machine rooms. Well, yeah. That's the door to the crevasses right there. Wait, where again? This way? What do I want to take? Is this the way up? Wait. Damn it. It's not working. I can't climb that? Where's the lever? Okay. I wonder if this entire place is going to fill with water. I'm thinking just that area. Navigation room. I do want to finish exploring, though. It's pretty important to me. As it turned out, I walked straight into her trap. She revealed to me that she wants to eliminate Eurydale Terwin and to merge her own consciousness with the Centurion. Oh, really? She... Yeah, I wasn't paying attention, but I don't remember her saying that she wanted to put her consciousness in there. She accused him of being a fool who didn't recognize the potential in the apotheosis, and she will use the machine to restore the old glory of the Starlings. I have to warn your eye. That goes out. I want to go to the navigation room. Hopefully your eye will be okay for a few minutes while I explore the rest. I'm thinking we're almost done with the crew quarters. Maybe. That is the way to the crew quarters. Navigation is the opposite way. Hopefully nothing is alive here. We destroyed everything, and everything is still destroyed. Is it this way? Yes. Those are the arrows that I dropped. I like that sound. Another master. Oh, I unlocked it with the key. Cool. Oh, there you are. What is that? Oh, those are like a huge chandelier or something. Ah, is that a centurion? I think so. Good news is we can just run back for the door. Starling Centurion, yep. You guys are in front, or at least him. Oh, ouch. Ouchie, ouchie. Almost filled me up, not quite. Gigantic piston. Expert lock. I think the one I have... I don't know why I keep going in there for that. I have adept, unfortunately. Ah! Enhanced aversion of fire, 23 coins, standard mana potion, standard the apothecary's potions. Yeah, I'll take those. A ruby, spell tome for Chaos Nova, rank 4. 30 points of entropic damage. Its damage rises 13% per 10% of your currently lost health. That's interesting. I always get confused. The spell tomes are in books and the learning books are in consumables. Anything else around? I hear the guardians. these. I thought I did. That's a chest. An empty chest. Starling arrows, hey. Learning book for mentalism masters. More starling arrows, sweet. Always a magic entropy. Empty dresser. Empty chest. Save early, save often. Happy that we're without enemies for a while, but I know it's not gonna last. Some soup. Good food. Oh boy. Oh crap. That wasn't too bad. Only one of them. Ectoplasm? Alright, goodies. Empty stuff. Starling helmet of the Master Smith. Wow. Starling sword, not that good. One of the health potions. Scrap metal. Morning air. All these dressers and stuff are empty. Oh, spell tome for Frost Wind, rank 4. Cool. This chest is not empty. Oh, 11 coins. That one is empty. Okay. And we still got this way, maybe? So back to the cargo area. So wait, where are we? Oh, we're headed back. So we've been this way. I just went around in a big circle. I think. Yeah. I'm gonna renew him when we get close. Been there. Yeah, it was that way. He's done anyway. Huh. divine shield right now. The mana come back a little more. As I always end up using all of it. Don't leave. Oh, this one's at full though. Eh. Got one. I used that up already. That thing's run out quickly. It's leaving. Don't trap me. Hopefully we can just finish this one off. And then we only have to finish the crew quarters. See one. I hear another one now. Oh, and look, there's something up there as well. Nice. So what is that up there? I hear a ghostie. Those look like fingers, like weird fingers, don't they? It doesn't sound that loud yet, does it? I'm not seeing it. It might be up there. Can't move those. I have to go up the ramp. Oh. It's funny, then you have a regular wooden chest in the middle of all this. 60 coins. I hear you, Ghosty. Are you up there? Yeah, that thing's gonna be hard to fight, I can imagine. Oh, brother. That must have been the one I heard walking around. We can pretty much safely take on one of them. But only one of them. Oh, is that to allow us quick exit out of this place? Are we gonna need to be leaving here in a hurry? Yeah, it looks pretty dangerous. You could drop down and then just run like hell that way. I don't imagine the thing could chase you that way. Probably through there, but if you drop down here... Should I just hit it from an arrow, like with an arrow from here? So I hear the ghost, too. Do I still have my, let me see. I don't. Alright. Doesn't seem to make much of a difference, but every little bit should help. Save here. Navigator. Navigator of Doom. Yay! We did it! Ooh, Veil of the Ash Warrior. Light armor fortified by 12 points. One-handed attacks do 10% more damage. Increase health by 10. 8% better prices. Soul of the Wandering Mage. Oh, he's found this before. Found it again. A filled Grand Soul Gem. Another key of Agnod's Mechanist, but we're in here. Kalian's Absolution. Ooh, look at that. A chance to paralyze target for 2 seconds. I wonder how much of a chance. Selna's Rage. Does... Wow, we can't carry all this. Does 14 points of frost damage to health and stamina. That was gonna fill me all the way up. Cool. Not too bad. Empty chests. And closer to the ghosty. He's like right around here somewhere. Let's see if I can get him. Why, hello there. Ooh! Starling Navigator, level 5.